Hello and welcome to this session on Jenkins beginner tutorial. This is the sixth session and today we are going to see some basic configurations on Jenkins. Okay, so let us go to our Jenkins and you see this manage Jenkins menu. I'll click here and then I will go to configure system. Okay, so step one is you go to your Jenkins, you go to manage Jenkins and then you go to configure system. Okay, and then inside this menu you can see some options are there, right? And today we are going to look all the common and basic options and configurations in Jenkins. Okay, so step two is get a understanding of common and some basic configuration. So this is what we'll do today. So let us begin, and inside the manage Jenkins and configure section, the very first thing that you see is the home directory. Okay, and this tells you where your Jenkins home directory is on this system, and all your plugins and other logs and related information will get into this particular home directory. Okay, so in case you want to change your home directory of Jenkins, you can watch one of my earlier tutorials, the third session on this series, how to change home directory. So this is this particular option gives you the information about your home directory. Okay, if you click on advanced, you can see there is a root directory and you can change the path from here, and then there is a build record directory. Okay, so what is a root directory? If you click on this help section, it will tell you the workspace where Jenkins will store all the build information. Okay, so all the build information and the workspace for this particular Jenkins is present here. Okay, and the root directory here, the Jenkins will store all the build records on the file system. Okay, so if you want, you can change it, however it is not recommended and you can keep it as it is. Okay, let us go to the system message. So what is a system message? Let me put some message here. This is an example system message, and let me go to preview, and what will happen is let me also start a new window. Okay, so I have put some message here and I will click on apply. Okay, and now you can see on my Jenkins home screen there is this message getting displayed. Okay, so if you want to display this message or notify your users with some particular message, you can put the system message here. The good thing is that you can provide HTML content here and you can use HTML tags. For example, I want to make it as heading 1. I will use the HTML tag H1 and close this tag and preview, and this is how it will display now. Apply it and let me go here, and yes, I'm getting an HTML message now. So you can use HTML tags, you can put an image or a link, anything, right? So this is how you can use a system message. In case you are not able to use the HTML tags, you should go to your manage Jenkins and configure global security and look at the markup formatter. If it is plain text, change it to safe HTML, save it, and then you should be able to use the HTML tags inside system message. Okay, let us go to number of executors. Now what does this mean is, the number of executors is the number of parallel jobs that this particular Jenkins instance should be able to run. So if we want that this Jenkins should run at max 5 parallel jobs, we can give the number here and it will run at the max 5 jobs at one time. Okay. To understand labels and the other usage of labels, we will need to go to node configuration, and I will just tell you very basics of what does this mean is. Let me go to my Jenkins and go to manage Jenkins, and if you go down you will see an option called manage nodes. Okay, now what does this mean is, in Jenkins we have a system for distributed builds. What does this that mean is, I can make my Jenkins as a master machine, and then I can add nodes to this particular Jenkins. So I can add different machines to this Jenkins, and I can say that the execution should take place on different nodes and not on the master machine. So for that I have to go to manage nodes, and you can see I can add a new node here. Okay, so adding a new node simply means that you are adding a new machine. I can say add new node, I can give any name. Let us say this is Windows 2, I make it permanent agent, and okay, and I have to give some configurations here. Okay, now here again we have number of executors, right? And here if we go to the help section, it will tell you the maximum number of concurrent build that the Jenkins may perform on this agent. Okay, so here I can control the maximum number of builds or jobs on this particular agent by giving the value for a number of executors. Okay, then we have the label here. So again, let us say if I give it a name as Windows Machine 2. Okay, and now I can say in the usage section, only build jobs with label expressions matching this node. Okay, what does this mean is, I can now, let me save this. Okay, let me also go to another node, let us say Windows Machine, go to configurations, and let me also add Windows Machine 1. Okay, I'm adding a labels here in different nodes, and I will just tell you what exactly is the use of these labels, and I'll clicking save. Okay, now see, I have added few nodes machine and I have given some labels to those node machines. Okay, now let me go to any of my existing jobs. You can also create a new job by clicking on the new item here. I am going to my existing job and saying configure. Okay, and now yes, in the general section you see this this option restrict where this project can be run. Okay, and now it gives you a label expression. Okay, and in this label expression I can give any expression which can be a regex. So see, as soon as I'm typing something, all the labels that I had added are coming by default. So Windows Machine 1, Windows Machine 2, and so on are coming. So if I select Windows Machine 1 here, okay, it is saying label is serviced by one node. That means this label is configured with only one node, and this particular job will be serviced by only this particular node which has the label Windows Machine 1. But I can also make it a regex. Okay, let me try it out. Okay, it is not taking the regex, but yeah, see, again Windows 2 is serviced by this particular label which has this particular label, the machine, and similarly I can use any label. Okay, so this is what the use of labels is in Jenkins, and we will look into it into very deeper details in the coming sessions, but for now you should be able to know that what does label means and how can we use it. Okay, so this is the use of labels. Okay, what is quiet period? So quiet period is the number of seconds that this particular Jenkins instance should wait before triggering a job. And why this is important is because suppose your job is auto scheduled to run at some particular time, or the job can be triggered as soon as the build take place. So if you go to a job configurations, you have build triggers, right? So you can trigger remotely, you can trigger periodically, or you can poll an SCM. Okay, so SCM means as soon as somebody will commit their code in a source repository like Git, the job will get triggered. Okay, but we want that there should be a time gap or there should be a sleep interval between the job getting triggered and the build actually getting into the source code repository. Okay, now the reason why we have this quiet period is because if we have it as zero or we do not have any quiet period, the job will get triggered as soon as there is the trigger coming to Jenkins. For example, there is a build committed into Git, the job will trigger. But we have seen that sometimes the commit is not successful or it takes some time in committing all the files. So by experience we'll come to know that our particular project or job, how much time gap does it require, and the same time gap we can give here as quiet period. Okay, now the next option is SCM checkout retry count. What does this mean is, as we have seen here, one of the build trigger is poll SCM. So what does this mean is, it will try to connect to a source code repository, okay, and it will try to get the latest build information. Okay, in case it fails, what is the maximum retry count our Jenkins should do? Okay, so that number we can specify here. Okay, the next option is restrict project naming, and by default the default option is selected, but we can also select role based strategy or pattern. Suppose I give a pattern and I say test. Okay, and now if I apply it, so see, if now I go to my Jenkins home page and go to new item, if I try to give any name for a new project, it will not take it because ABC does not match the job name convention pattern test.star. So I am now forced to give a name which starts from test and then anything after that, right? And then it will take it. Okay, so this is the use of this restrict project naming. So in case you want to restrict your Jenkins project naming so that people use some default naming conventions, we can use this option. As of now, I am putting it back to default. The next option is global properties. Okay, now global properties, as the name suggests, we can define some global properties or the properties at a global level which can be used by all the jobs in Jenkins. So for example, we can add some variable. Let us say I add some key and some value. Now this, let us say this is key 1 and its value is 1. Okay, now after I add this, this becomes available for all the jobs in a Jenkins, and I can refer this value by this key. So I can refer this like this, dollar key 1. Okay, or we can also say dollar key 1. Okay, now do not get intimidated with all the information I am giving it to you right now. This is just a basic understanding of different configuration options. I will cover all these in details and into deeper insights in my coming sessions. Okay, so as of now, let me delete it. Okay, again, you can give some tool locations which you want should be at a global level and can be accessed by any job. Okay, now the next option is Jenkins location. So normally we start our Jenkins, if we are on a local machine, we say localhost 8080, but you can also, instead of localhost, you can give the IP of your machine. So in case if you have noticed, Today, instead of starting on localhost, I am giving the IP of my machine. So you can get the IP of your machine by going to command prompt on Windows and typing ipconfig. Or if you are on a Mac, you can go to terminal and type ifconfig, or you can also go to your network preferences and get your IP from there. And the same you can put it here. So if I can put my IP here, okay, and so on. You can put some your admin email address here, okay. The SSH server, so in case you want your Jenkins to run a job remotely and connect to some server, you can give the port numbers here, and we will cover this into details in the coming sections. And the last option is shell. So by default, Jenkins has a bash shell on which it executes all the shell commands, but in case you want to give some root directory or some other shell, for example you have configured Sigwin on your system and you want that all the executable commands should be executed on the Sigwin, you can give the location of the executable here. For example, if you are on Windows, and in Windows it is cmd.exe where the commands get executed. So by default it will take the location of your cmd.exe. In case you have changed the location, you can provide it here so that Jenkins know that from where I have to execute the executable commands. Okay, so this is all about the very basic configurations of Jenkins, and please do not get intimidated by all the information I have provided you in this sessions. We will cover all these configurations and settings into deeper details as we go through the jobs and other settings in the coming series. Okay, so hope you like it. Thank you.